Hello everyone, we are going to study Hall effect in a semiconductor now. Hall effect is defined as, when a magnetic field is applied perpendicular to a current carrying semiconductor. This is a semiconductor and the magnetic field is applied perpendicular to a current carrying semiconductor. Current is in this positive x direction and the magnetic field is applied perpendicular to this, that is y direction. Then a voltage is developed in the material perpendicular to both magnetic field and current in a semiconductor. This effect is known as Hall effect and the voltage developed is known as Hall voltage. Let us derive Hall coefficient for n-type semiconductor. In your syllabus, you have Hall coefficients in p-type semiconductor also. Okay? So if you know Hall coefficients for n-type semiconductor, then p-type semiconductor is easy, just the sign changes there, because charge of the electron here is minus E for n-type and it is charge of the holes in p-type is plus E. Now, let's consider a semiconductor strip which is placed on the coordinate axis, and since this is n-type semiconductor, the charge carriers are electrons in this, and current is flowing along OX, then the electrons must be moving along XO. You can see the direction here, velocity direction. Okay. And the charge of the electron is minus E. Okay. Then the force on the electrons due to the magnetic field is F is equal to minus BEV, which acts along OZ. So the electrons which are present here experiences a force because of the applied magnetic field, and that causes the electrons to accumulate on phase A, B, E, F, which becomes completely negative. Because of this negative charge here, positive charge is developed on O, C, D, G. So A, B, E, F becomes positive because of the force experienced by the electrons in the semiconductor resulted in electrons are pushed to this phase, and that results in OCDG becomes positive. So potential is developed between these two phases. That potential is called as Hall voltage. Now, before this, a potential difference which is established between these two, ABEF and OCDG, causes the field called as Hall field, and it is represented as EH. And that field is applied on the electrons which are in ABEF in the opposite direction. So this force is applied in positive z direction, and this minus EEH is applied in the negative z direction. Then the equilibrium will be set up. So minus EEH is equal to minus BEV. Call this equation number 1, where V is the drift velocity, so which results in EH is equal to B into V, because you can cancel here E. Now if D is the distance between the upper and lower surface of the slab, then EH is equal to VH divided by D, that is electric field is defined like this. Now VH becomes D into EH. Let us substitute equation 2 in equation 3. Equation 2 is EH is equal to BV. Equation 3 is VH is equal to D into EH. So this equation becomes VH is equal to BV. T calls this equation number 4. We know that the current I is equal to minus N E A V. This equation you are all familiar with this. I is equal to minus N E A V. Since you are doing this derivation for N type semiconductor, it is minus E. Okay. If your derivation is for P type semiconductor, this becomes plus E. And remaining all steps becomes plus. This is what is the difference between n-type semiconductor and p-type semiconductor when you do Hall coefficient derivation. This you have to remember. Now let's continue. V is equal to minus I divided by n e a from this equation. Substitute this equation number 6, V is equal to minus I divided by NEA in equation number 4. Yeah. We will get VH is equal to minus VID divided by NEA. So we know that EH is equal to VH divided by D. Substitute this in equation 8. We will get EH is equal to minus VI divided by NEA. Let us keep this equation as it is, and EH is equal to minus JB by NE is obtained from this equation because I by A is J, which is equal to the current density. Current density is defined as current divided by area of cross section, that is I divided by A. So minus JB divided by NE. Now we know that in a semiconductor the Hall field EH is proportional to the current density J and intensity of magnetic field B in the material. That is EH is proportional to J into B. So to remove the proportionality constant is required. EH is equal to some proportionality constant into JB. Okay. So that proportionality constant is nothing but RH. So EH is equal to RH JB. So this proportionality constant RH is called as Hall coefficient, is referred as Hall coefficient. So RH is equal to EH divided by JB. Now let us compare this equation with equation number 9. You can write RH is equal to minus 1 divided by NE by substituting this EH is equal to minus JB by NE here in place of EH. We'll get RH is equal to minus 1 by NE, which is the Hall coefficient for N type semiconductor. Now if you do for P type semiconductor, you should get here RH is equal to plus 1 by NE, where RH is called as Hall coefficient, which is defined as Hall field generated in the material per unit magnetic field when the current density is unity. The SI unit of Hall coefficient is meter cube per coulomb. So this Hall effect is useful as a means to measure either current density or the magnetic field. So if current density is not known and Hall coefficient is given, you can determine the current density. And the value of N is known, you can also determine the Hall coefficient also. Now another advantage of this Hall coefficient is you can determine whether the semiconductor is N-type semiconductor or P-type semiconductor by observing this sign. If the RH is negative, then the semiconductor is n-type, and if the RH is positive, then the given semiconductor is p p-type semiconductor.